right. Intercepting the GOAT.
Yep.
How's that feel?
Oh, man. I can't even explain it. Obviously, everybody grew up watching Tom Brady. Obviously, he is the GOAT. So, you know, to have that to the collection, I was telling Huff earlier, like, man, that's the one guy that I haven't got. Like, you know, I got some GOATs, man. I've been around a long time, so, but I never had time, man. I played them many times, obviously. So today was special, especially with the victory. It's a real humbling experience, man. And I'm just blessed, you know. Glory be to God.
The defense is humming right now. What specifically has changed so much since that stretch of Atlanta, Kansas City?
You know, honestly, I think that we just looked ourselves in the mirror and understood the type of guys we have on this side of the ball. Honestly, I mean, with the guys that we have on this side of the ball, starting with the D-line, the linebackers, those two guys, man, Aziz as well, in the secondary, man, just playing complimentary football. I think that that's been the biggest thing. So, you know, we had to look ourselves after that Chief game. Sometimes you need games like that, man, to kind of humble you a little bit. And I think that was our wake-up call, man. And since then, we've been rolling offensively, defensively, and special teams. So we just playing good complimentary football right now. And it's just it's a great day to be a 49er for sure.
Speaking of that complimentary football, your rookie quarterback went out there and balled out today. What did you see from him?
Same thing we've been seeing, man. I think Fred spoke on it last week, man. You know, he go against the best defense in the league, man, week in and week out. So when his time came, he answered that call. So, you know, we definitely back him. We behind him, man. And he just going out there making plays, man. He a baller. And, you know, I tip my hat to him, man. I couldn't be more happier for him, man, to step in right now, in the thick of things right now. So for him to go out there and play the way he's been playing, it's huge, man. It's phenomenal. Be young, man. And the moment don't seem too big for him, man. He's definitely comfortable in his element right now.
You said that you've been around for a while, so you've seen a lot of rookie quarterbacks throughout the year. It seems like he has so much moxie and just swagger and confidence. Do you see that from many rookies?
It's hard. It's hard to come in this league, man, and have that type of swagger, obviously. You know, it's growing pains. You got to think he haven't played much football outside of the preseason. So for him to come in and make this type of impact, man, essentially he had this is his first week as a starter. So you got to tip your hat off to him, man. The sky's the limit. You know, obviously confidence is key in this business. And the way he's been playing, man, the confidence he's been exuding out there, hopefully it continue to grow, man, and he continue to lead this team the right way, man, and let everything else take care of itself.
How important was it for you guys as a defense to provide that extra support for him on the other side of the ball, knowing that, you know, it was his first start in all the circumstances?
You know, I think our biggest thing was we just wanted to go out there and play our brand of football. We understood that we did what we needed to do. We'd give them the boost that the offense need, obviously. So we want to put the game on our shoulders. That's what we're going each week, no matter who's that quarterback. Obviously, knowing that we have him back there, we want to make the game as easy as possible for him. But, hey, he made the game easy for us on the defensive side of the ball. So, again, tip my hat off to him. You know, complimentary football. He's playing lights out, man. He went out there and did his thing today.
How much did you enjoy hearing the stadium chanting his name?
Man, it's crazy. Like, to hear it like that, man, it's pretty cool, man. I know it had to be a humbling experience for him, man, a young guy, man. Didn't know when this opportunity was going to come, man. To be in this moment right now, on this team right now, the way that we're rolling, it got to be humbling for him, man. And, you know, I don't know how he feel, man, but if you ask him, I'm sure, man, it probably was a moment he probably had never forget.
Did you get a chance to say anything to Brady after the game?
Oh, shook his hand. Like, you know, Dre Greenlaw got the ball signed for me. So, I'm in debt for Dre. To Dre, man, I appreciate it. But, no, I just, you know, kind of just exchange pleasantries, man, as I always do after games, man. Obviously, tip my hat off to him, man. He's the greatest to ever do it. So, it's always fun going out there matching up with guys like that.
How about the injury course of Debo? I mean, how much is that kind of bittersweet when you have a win like this and you guys get, unfortunately, another member of your offense?
I mean, when you think about one of the most dynamic guys in the National Football League, it's always tough to lose a guy like that. I don't know the severity of it. Hope it's not too serious. But, you know, when you lose a guy like that, that's a morale killer, obviously. You need those type of guys like that, man. It's the offense is just so much more explosive with a guy like that. Any offense would be. So praying that it's something minor, that he'll shake back, man, because we're going to need him down the stretch.